Brandon Gaughan, Charles Davis, ready for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup as you get a peek at some of the big players in today's game, and you're a big player in today's game as well. Let's get the party started. Going back to their AFL days in the 1960s, the Chiefs and Raiders are underway. This fielded at the 2. It'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. Five wides in the game, four of them to the right side. Throwing now is Brady. He gets it into the hands of Larry Fitzgerald. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. They get 25 yards out of that one. And that'll be good for a KC first down. A give to the game's all-time leader, Emmitt Smith. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4. So the first carry of the game under the belt for Emmitt Smith, and of course in his career over 18,000 rushing yards, the all-time leader.
He can probably rest easy for a while about people chasing that number down. He's going to stay at the top because everyone's flinging it around instead of running it. We're going to need a real running back renaissance and an emphasis on the ground game to put that record in jeopardy. Is anyone even close right now?
Well, Frank Gore about 6,000 away, and then AP 7,000 away still around there.
Wow, that's a lot of yards to make up. I think Emmitt Smith feels pretty good about the number he posted, 18,355 yards.
They get 9 yards there, and they get a first down.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it, because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
A whole group of Raiders there that time helped bring him down.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
To the right side, it's Kelce. And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Travis Kelce, 33 yards. And the Chiefs are going to take a first quarter lead. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told, as he's taken down back shy of the 20. They'll start the drive with a give to White. And a short pickup there as he'll take this up to right around the 20. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Yeah, that wasn't a big run, just a short one there. But guess what? Sometimes you treat it like boxing. You throw that jab out there, and you throw it again, and you throw it again. Then you come with a big punch later. Maybe they're just trying to set him up.
Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. James White, the man he was looking for out of the backfield. And that'll make it third down.
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
Now, he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision. And receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he is going to lose yardage here. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Good luck trying to get your running game going against Ndamukong Suh. I mean, he is so strong. Just trying to move him, take one guy, two guys, whatever. I wish you a whole lot of luck. He usually converts an offensive running game into rubble.
Carr to throw on second down. And this will be incomplete. Emmanuel Sanders, the intended receiver. And it's third down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. And Hill with it over the middle. Just a 5-yard pickup, but it leads to fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say, I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. Now Carr. And this is incomplete. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And the Chiefs will have the football back in excellent field position. Brady now on first down. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
And there's a good opportunity. Just went awry there. A drop pass. I guess that's why they call them running backs and not catching backs.
Brady will try again on second down. His throw incomplete. Larry Fitzgerald was the intended target, and now it's third down.
Let's give some credit to the defensive guys on that play. Able to bat that one away. Sure looked like they were trying to hit the corner route.
Third down here for the offense after the incomplete pass. On play action, it's Brady. Finding time, and incomplete here on third down. Tim Brown, the intended target, and it's fourth down. Charles, that's an important third down stop. You don't want to spot him two touchdowns here early.
You're trying to slow momentum down. You've already given up the score. They're coming right back at you. You're exactly right. Being able to hold them there and force a decision on fourth down, that's big for the defense.
And that'll hit in the end zone. Much too much leg there. That'll be a touchback. Now the Oakland offense heading back onto the field to take over. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on fourth, turned it over in their own territory. But the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold up.
But he trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it. Be aggressive, because I've got the wild bunch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
Now we'll see what his offense can do. Now on first down, this is White on the screen, and he'll lose yardage here back at the 41. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. Got to give some credit there defensively. They snuffed out that screen early on first down.
Really read it well, didn't they? Because they didn't bring the pressure that they expected. They covered all the passing lanes. So once you see it break down as the passer, I think in this situation, you're throwing it at the feet of your back to make sure no one picks it off, or you throw it away, throw it over the sideline. Don't try and freelance and try and make a bigger play. There's really no one else running a pattern that should be open.
And to give this time to the tailback. And he gets this one across midfield for the first down to the 46. Only three there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
Everyone understood their role on that play. Third and one. You know, the defensive guys, they're trying to get down and get low and get leverage on the offensive linemen, but they didn't allow that to happen. They created a crease and allowed him to get through for a first down.
So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. He'll get only a couple down to the 44. And Ndamukong Suh makes the tackle.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks. And it looks like this will likely be the last play before we hit the two-minute warning.
Let's see if they can sneak one more good play in before the two-minute signal.
Carr gonna throw. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. We'll come back to Oakland after this. Carr again here on 2nd and 10. And he will not get away from the pressure here. Carr taken down. Michael Bannon, he's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9. 9th play of the drive now on 3rd and a country mile. Now a play fake. Carr. And that is incomplete.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
With it is Brown. Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially, give him 15. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. Now the Chiefs offense, they get ready to head on the field. To throw is Brady. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. On 1st down, Brady. Looking for Fitzgerald, and it's intercepted. And nothing but green grass here, middle of the field. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Raider defense delivers a score. Short throw, pick 6 right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And now here comes Kansas City. On 1st and 10, here's Brady. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. 1 receiver left, that's Allen. Brady now on 1st down. Fitzgerald's got it right side. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
Everything about that play was beautiful. Beautiful. A great corner route where the receiver worked the defensive back inside and then broke back to the outside to the corner. But how about the throw by the quarterback? Anticipation. On the break from inside to outside, he threw the football. As the receiver turned around, the ball greeted him.
Throwing on 1st down is Brady. It's complete. It's Fitzgerald. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. It'll go as a gain of 12, and the Chiefs are going to have a 1st down. And now the offense operates in the red zone. Into the red zone, it's Brady. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be 2nd down.
Really nice play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball, but for the guys on the offensive line, they're doing a nice job of trying to protect their passer. But when a guy hops in the air and goes airborne to try and knock one away, it's difficult because you can't reach out and grab him. That'll be a holding penalty. So all you're trying to do is make some type of a play on him, make some type of contact to try and get his arms out of the sky.
And his throw is going to be incomplete.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
Now play number 7 of the drive as they're looking at a 3rd and 10. Throwing is Brady on third down. And he can't come up with a pick. Nearly his second of the game. Instead, fourth down. So on fourth down, Andy Reid decides to send in the field goal unit. Right hash, 37-yard attempt. And this one is no good. He missed it. And this score will stay right where it is.
Everything looked good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it. And this one winds up no good.
They begin the drive on the ground. It's White. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. All right. Hang on here. We'll jump over halftime. Just let the system and graphics catch up. Okay. All set. Third quarter now. Tyreek Hill on the return. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Out comes the Raiders offense. They'll go on offense first to start quarter number three. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up. And we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. And he's got his man on the out route. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
Here's Carr. And he's got a new one. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
Did you see that route the way that I did? I thought he was trying to get deep.
Yeah, that wasn't the first option.
No, not doing it. It came off of that guy, the deep guy, and came underneath on the drag, completed it very well.
Now Carr. Now this is Carr. It's Greg Olsen. And he's going to be marked down deep into Kansas City territory. A big play that time for the Raiders. 45 yards. Into the red zone. It's Carr. That is caught inside the five. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Emmanuel Sanders, a 14-yard touchdown. And the Raiders have taken the lead. Carr will look to throw. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Derek Johnson. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. A look at the offense now here coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Officially no gain on the play, and they're left with a third and eight. Big boys down there in the trenches and a nice play to stop them cold. Nothing there.
Yeah, when you talk about big boys, you talk about those defensive tackles, those nose tackles.
They're not just big, they're immense. And what a big-time play there.
And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. And he's certainly not a guy that drops that football very often.
Indeed, because that's a bit of a surprise. I know he's in the middle of some traffic and people, bodies all around him, but he usually has the focus to haul that one in.
So here we go. The offense is going to stay out there. They're going for it on fourth and eight. One receiver left. That's Allen. They do go for it. It's Brady. And it's complete to Kelsey. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. I don't know if I agree with that. I guess they don't care if I agree with that. But, boy, you have to be surprised by that, right?
I definitely was surprised that they decided to go for it in this situation. But they must have either felt like they either had a great play call on or they're trying to show extreme confidence.
A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. And yet again, this run game just continues to be completely shut off.
Completely stymied. I mean, they're trying to get some consistency, trying to find places to roam. They just haven't been there throughout this game.
And his throw here is incomplete. Travis Kelce, the Pro Bowl tight end, the intended target. Third down here. So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third. One receiver left, two to the right. On third and long, it's Brady. Finds his target, Montgomery. And able to pick up the first across midfield to the 47.
It's a nice job hitting him on the angle route there. Come out of the backfield, cutting sharply across the middle. And that's good timing between the quarterback and his receiver.
Effective third down play to move the chains. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
Not only did we just see back-to-back nice gains, but we're also seeing the confidence rise, not just for the guy who caught it, but the guy throwing it as well.
Into a double team, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And he'll bring this one back to the 29. The Raiders offense now, they trot back out. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good. So they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense. And they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. Well, they'll take that every time with a lead, first down, fourth quarter, getting 8 yards. Carr to throw on second down. Got an open man. It's a noon one. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at it, and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out, to the sideline, and make a catch.
And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and four. See if they stay on the ground for second down. Time running out here on the play clock. On second down, here's Carr. And that's incomplete. And that was incomplete, but I don't know how much of that falls on the quarterback. He was pressured.
Brandon, the rush showed up so fast, the quarterback had no chance to get the ball downfield.
And at this stage of the game, time a factor, time on their side as they just try to eke out the final precious moments of this one. And Hill with it over the middle. And he has the first down yardage before they bring him down right at the 45.
But give the defensive guys a little bit of credit. They didn't let the deep ball beat them on that play, did they?
No, the drag, that guy can be your safety valve. We saw it right there.
Yeah, and it picked up a first down for him, too.
They'll need to get the playoff quickly. They'll give it to him right off the gun. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. They come out here in the eye. And he'll give it here to his running back. And that. Now here's a defensive timeout called by the Chiefs. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Carr to throw. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Putting pressure on the guy throwing the football is always good, but when you can couple that with contact on him that leads to an incompletion, as we just saw there, that's winning football.
They'll get off a fairly short kick here as this is toward the sideline. And now where will the side judge stop his walk? That's the question. He says it crossed out of bounds at about the 17-yard line. Now the Chiefs offense, they get ready to head on the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
Second down now after the pass completion. Back to throw. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. A gain of four on the play, and that'll make it third down. Still in search of the first down after that last completion. They brought in an extra defensive back here, so probably not expecting a run on third and three.
A good call.
And this is going to be incomplete. His favorite target, Travis Kelce, the intended receiver. And it's fourth down. And down by five, they've got to go for it here on fourth down. Now Brady got to have this one. And now a fumble. Brady loses the football. And this defense has broken it open as they return it to the house for six. This was a close game. They needed a little breathing room. Boy, they got it right there on that return for a touchdown.
Yeah, we would say that this could be huge. Forget it. It was huge. Gave him a comfortable lead.
And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. This fielded at the two. And he will be marked down right there at the 20-yard line. And now here comes Kansas City. Throwing on first down is Brady. And his throw is incomplete. Keenan Allen, the intended target, and it's second down.
In most pass defenses, the guy playing safety has the ability to roam free and try and go to the football. But when you're a man, you've got to cover just like the guy playing out on the corner. Lock up on the receiver and go to the football. That's exactly what he did, batting that one away.
It'll be a gain of nine, and that'll make it third and one. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Here's Brady to throw. And he's got a man open. That's Allen. Pass the 20. And he takes this one into the end zone. And all of a sudden, here in the final minute, things get a little bit tighter.
And there's the touchdown that they needed. So they'll celebrate. But the guys on the sidelines, they've got to stay focused. The onside kick team, they need them to get the ball back.
Yeah, part one of the equation done. Now they need to convert and get that onside kick. So a little under 50 seconds to go. Plenty of time if they can get this onside kick. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. Fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we've brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. And they'll indeed take a knee. Here's Sam Cook now, as he's on to punt for Oakland. Kansas City. They have time here, partner, for just one final heave.
And I have to look at from the defense's perspective here. We know what they're going to do on offense. The Hail Mary, try and get guys down there and throw it in the end zone, tip it around and catch it. You've got to have guys back.
And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Calvin Pryor. And that is going to seal this victory as time runs out. Well, we were on hand for a fun and entertaining game here, coming down really to that last play. Great job defensively to get the pick and seal it.
And we know that every play during a game matters. You're never sure which one's going to be one of the key ones. But at the end of the game, when you analyze it, 3, 4, 5 plays are going to be the ones you focus on. And that last play was one of them. The last shot, had to take it. And they came up with the interception and sealed their victory.
So that'll do it from here for Charles Davis and the rest of our crew. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com/Madden. The Black Hole celebrates. The Raiders are winners here as we say so long from Oakland.